Well, look what we have here. Someone with flesh on their bones. Let's just say I sold something to a guy who turned out to work for a whole coven of necromancers. How in the name of Zenithar was I to know the ingredients were for me? Do I look like someone that would double-cross a necromancer? You got it. Horse, wagon, and all. Plopped here without so much as a word. I used to be one of the best traders in High Rock, you know. Oh, people would track me down just to see what I had for sale. Very funny. And what exactly are you going to pay me with? Take a look around. Gold doesn't exactly win you any friends around here. I'll tell you what. I appreciate what you're trying to do, so I'll play along. The only thing I see around here in abundance are soul husks. You know, those ugly fungus-looking things growing out of the ground. Bring me, say, 25 of them, and you can rummage through what was left on my cart. Odds and ends I've gathered over the years. Well, used to gather, before all of this nonsense happened to me. Tell me what you're looking for, and maybe we can make a deal, if you have the husks. No husks, no sale. Guess you have some scavenging to do.
Consumes me. What a horrible place. Get out while you can. Please, end this misery.
You must help me find my Arvak. He doesn't deserve to be in a place like this. Arvak, my horse. We came to this horrible place together. We were attacked by monsters, so I told him to run. Please, he's such a loyal creature, and he's been running for so long. You have to save him. A place like this will change you. Arvak? Arvak! Where are you? Arvak, please come back! Come back! Can't I just die? I fear I'm cursed to walk this desolate land forever. Could I know it would trap my soul? Thank you. You saved him! His soul is free, I can feel it! He's such a loyal beast. Here, I'll teach you how to call him to you. He'll help you get around this wretched place. But I'm sure he'd be much happier someplace sunnier. Goodbye, hero. Take good care of Arvak for me. Such a good horse.
What do you want? How does anyone expect me to write my bonus with all of these rude interruptions? What do I mean, indeed? If I hadn't lost all of the pages, I wouldn't be in this predicament, and we wouldn't be having this conversation.
Thank you.
lost all of the pages, I wouldn't be in this predicament, and we wouldn't be having this conversation. Very well. I suppose a moment or two of my time couldn't hurt. I am Jib. Some call me Saint Jib. Others call me Jib the Eradicator. Perhaps you've heard of me. I can't say that I'm surprised by your answer. Until I get my second volume published, no one will ever know of my achievements. A book? I'd hardly call a 26-volume epic simply a book. Surely you've heard of the rise and fall of Saint Jib the Eradicator, hero of Morrowind and savior of the Dunmer. Terrible. Simply terrible. I was in the midst of writing the second volume, and they just threw me into this prison. It's unfair. His minions. They didn't even give me a chance to explain who I was. Well, I assume so. It cast a spell at me from some kind of strange black crystal. Next thing I knew, I arrived here. My what? Wait. That means... No. All these wasted months. Or has it been years? I don't even remember how much time has passed. Now my work will never see the light of day. My name will be forgotten. Perhaps. Do you have a way out of here? Maybe I can't leave. But my writings can. In order to write the second volume of my opus, I need the notes from my first volume. Otherwise, I need to do all of this from memory. When I was tossed in here, I felt myself falling, and I dropped the pages I had been holding. There were 10 of them in all. Find them for me, please. I beg you. Everyone traveling through here has said that the Oblivion Gates have been opening all over Tamriel. Has it been that long? Oh my. Well, it started with the followers of Mehrunes Dagon having Emperor Uriel Septim VII assassinated. Without a Septim on the throne of the Empire, Dagon was able to leave Oblivion through the gates and attack. All I heard is that without a Septim sitting on the throne of the Empire, the dragon fires in a place called the Temple of the One were no longer lit. This meant that we were vulnerable to the forces of Oblivion. Well, I don't know. Everything seemed fine until that Remora attacked me. I only heard later about the gates from the other souls. I can only assume the gates have been closed by now. Ah, yes. Say Jib, Jib the Eradicator, Jib the Magnificent. I've earned a lot of those titles thanks to my campaign against the Winged Menace. Yes, I'm speaking of the Cliff Racer, of course. Wretched things. They used to crisscross the skies over Morrowind like vermin. Nasty flying creatures with a habit of sneaking up on the unwary. After I was freed from prison, I decided to turn my life around. Give something back to the people of Morrowind. It became quickly apparent that the best way I could help would be by wiping out the Cliff Racer. Indeed I was. I hunted down and killed every last one of them. Took years. The people of Morrowind were so grateful to have the roads safer again, they took to calling me St. Jiub. Then the other names followed. I had just moved from my ancestral home in Morrowind to the continent of Cyrodiil. I settled in the city of Kavaj to write my memoirs and to find some peace and quiet. Indeed, one moment I was writing diligently, and the next, the door bursts open. It was a cadre of Dremoran. The city was under attack. I took it upon myself to join the cause and fight the Dremora, thinking this would simply be another feather in my cap. The reason I'm standing in front of you, as only a whisper of my former self, should tell you that. I never knew what became of Kavaj. I wonder if they were triumphant about me. That was a dark time in my life. I did a lot of things I ended up regretting. Maybe that's why I worked so hard to redeem myself once I was freed. I murdered others for money. Before you think I belong to some romantic or secretive guild, think again. I was simply an addict who needed money for skooma. The stuff wasn't cheap, and murder always seemed to be in demand. I finally bit off more than I could chew. I was paid to assassinate some high-ranking official from House Redoran. What I didn't know is someone had hired the Morag Dong to kill him as well. Exactly. He got to my target first. He called the guard to cover his tracks. By the time I got there, the place was on alert. Walked right into a trap and didn't even realize it until I was captured. They tried me for murder. Threw me on a prison ship and sent me to the jail in Vivek City. Gave me a lot of time to think, that's for sure. Thanks again for searching. I don't know what I'd do with a... pages.
Thank you.
Some soul husks? Sure, got plenty. What am I gonna do with it? Sure, here you go. Can't understand a word of it. Maybe it'll do you some good.
Family misses me. Wonder if they're still alive. How much time has passed?
Did they listen? Of course not.
Last time I argue with a Dromora.
Thank you.